Whether you've managed to purchase your own name as a URL or you have a domain for your small business or freelancing setup, it is absolutely critical to not only take steps to protect your privacy, but also build an added layer of security that most people don't even think about. Welcome to All Things Secured. My name's Josh, and I personally own over 30 different domains, which for some of you might seem like a lot, but the reality is that when you're running businesses online, that's actually a small number of URLs. I know a lot of people who are using custom domain names, which is something like yourbusinessname.com or even yourpersonalname.com. And unfortunately, they have no clue that there are important security and privacy settings available to them for their domain. So let's go ahead and change that. Did you know that you can look up any domain and get the owner's name, phone number, address, and when the domain will expire? If you've never done it before on your own domain, it's definitely worth trying. Go ahead and pause this video, visit something like godaddy.com/whois, and check your domain right now. Okay, we good? What did you find? I mean, hopefully all you saw was proxy information like what you see here for allthingssecured.com. But if your real name, phone number, and address showed up, or even that of your business, you need to make some changes for the sake of your privacy and, frankly, the amount of spam you're probably having to deal with right now. To do this, log into your domain registrar. That's the company that hosts your domain, not your website, although sometimes they are one and the same. I'm talking about companies like GoDaddy, Namecheap, Google Domains, or others. Within your domain dashboard, you're looking for something called domain privacy, which for the major registrars is included for free. So if you're being asked to pay for it, you might want to consider changing registrars. Make sure this privacy setting is turned on. Now, let's say you did want to change registrars or even sell your domain at some point. If your domain is not locked, it's surprisingly easy to make that transfer or even get caught in a phishing scam, and the last thing you want is somebody stealing your domain name without your explicit consent. And that's where domain lock comes in. Again, you'll find this in the settings of every registrar, and hopefully it's on by default. Basically, what this means is that as long as a lock is turned on, your domain can't be transferred. You would need to personally log into your registrar account, turn off the domain lock, and then make the transfer request. It's an added step, but one that's building an important layer of security. By the way, a little bonus tip here, GoDaddy and Namecheap, two of the biggest domain registrars, both will try to upsell you on added domain protections. I'm sure others do something like this as well. Basically, what they're saying is that we'll require even more identity checks in order to make any kind of change on your account. And maybe that would give you some peace of mind, but honestly, as long as you have your domain set to auto-renew, you keep an updated payment method on file, and you lock the domain like we just talked about, those premium protections feel like an unnecessary expense to me. It's alarming to me how many businesses and people I see using custom domains for email who haven't set up basic protections on that domain. Now, I've already done a video explaining how this works, but the important thing you need to know is that without these protections, anybody can send an email using your domain and make it look like it's coming from you. I could pretend to be you or your business and make a request for payment or find a way to scam your customers. It's really just a bad look, especially when the solution is so simple. You need to set up what are known as DMARC records. And you can watch this video next where I explain how to set that up manually. But if you give it a try and find that it's too complicated, and you wouldn't be the first to say that, so don't be ashamed, I recommend a service I've used for a couple years now called Easy DMARC. Now, they've graciously sponsored this video, so it may seem like I'm incentivized to say what I'm about to say, but let me tell you, I've set up DMARC on my own before, and the deluge of DMARC reports that hit my inbox was unbelievable. These reports are critical to understand when and how to move to a DMARC reject policy, which is what you need to work toward. But if you can't read the report, it's of no value to you. Now, Easy DMARC takes responsibility for all of these reports. It pulls it out of my inbox, and then they present me with an easy to understand dashboard that alerted me, for example, when somebody in Russia was trying to use the All Things Secure domain to send scam email. Yes, that really happened. Visit easydmarc.com to test your own domain and to see how easy it is to protect it from being spoofed for email scams by bad actors. If you've been following here on All Things Secured for any amount of time, you're probably sick of hearing me talk about two-factor authentication, or 2FA for short. I'm pretty sure it comes up at some point in almost every video I do now. So I've decided to give you a break and no longer talk about 2FA anymore. Yeah, that's not happening. 2FA is just too daggum important for you to ignore, so I'm going to keep beating that drum until a better security option comes along. In this case, setting up 2FA can be applied in a number of different places to protect your domain. It absolutely needs to be set up with your domain registrar, but if you're using, let's say, a different DNS service like Cloudflare, you absolutely need to set it up there too. And yes, you need 2FA for your domain email provider, whether you use Google Workspace or a more private option like ProtonMail, for example. And when you set up 2FA, as best you can, try to avoid using the SMS text option and instead opt for the authenticator app, or better yet, a physical 2FA key. In both cases, this means that if somebody wants to try to steal your domain, which you've already locked, right, then they would need to not only know your username and password, they would also need to have access to your method of two-factor authentication. We're adding layers of security here. Nothing is foolproof, of course, but it makes you less and less of an easy target. Be sure to follow each of these steps, and thanks again to EasyDMARC for sponsoring this video. Visit them at EasyDMARC.com and give yourself the peace of mind knowing that your domain email protection is being done right. Oh, and watch one of these videos next.